Previously on Balls.
Fleet bollocks. That was absolutely brilliant. Zwei Mapala is just an ordinary Kaiser Chiefs fan. He's been a fan since he was 6 or 7. He cries when they lose. He kicks the coffee table. That's what he said. His wife has to run out the house. Okay, these are football fans. These are the people that make the game tick. They pay their 40 rand. They have the right to express themselves. And when they see Stuart Baxter week after week playing Kingston and Carter, they agree that Stuart Baxter should back Kingston and Carter, but they say the only way we can influence our coach, like when Nicholas Bentner plays for Arsenal because they couldn't get him off the transfer list, they boo. I'm going to get shakes in a minute. We've got some scenes, haven't we? Comfort K, my producer, Comfort Keswa, who's an Orlando Pirates fan, by the way. Wasn't that interesting, Comfort, when Zwei said that he didn't celebrate Kingston and Carter's goal, not because it's Kingston and Carter, but because it was offside. And you've got to say that Enoch Malefi, you know, maybe his right arm stopped working. He's 48 now. He retired as an international linesman. I'd love to speak to Enoch. I did try and get his number off a couple of people. I couldn't get to him. Everyone makes mistakes. I'm not going to pillory the bloke, but it was definitely an offside goal. We're getting a lot of response on Twitter, guys, at Neil Cole and at Balls Radio with a Z. At K Comfort K as well. You can Twitter us. We've also got an SMS line, 47766. Is that on our visual now? On www.balls.co.za, we've got some visuals from the Soweto Derby, including the notorious booing of Kingston and Carter, the Zimbabwean lad who is a talented player. I thought he played quite well for Zimbabwe against Bafana when they beat them. But he's getting a lot of flack, Kingston and Carter. Stuart Baxter defends him every week, says we've got to stop booing him. And when he scored the goal, he definitely put a finger up on his lips to the crowd as if to say quiet. And he did the old quacking movement with his hand as if to say, you know, guys, you can shut up now, I've just scored. But it was offside. Sorry, guys. I went past a Kaiser Chiefs fan yesterday. You know, people know I'm a football bloke. And one of them, you know, on the road yesterday, Kaiser Chiefs fan in the Kaiser Chiefs shirt shouted, offsides for life. I thought that kind of summed up the situation. Offsides for life after that goal. And after a game that was very, very interesting. I had a great picture of Ntumelinkune giving Victor Kungwane, the referee, a little pat on the bottom. You know, before the game. And so much debate around that goal. And, of course, with Orlando Pirates playing the Champions League final, yet another draw for Drawlando. I think it's 6 out of 10 they've drawn. Tumle, Marire88 on Twitter says, this is reckless and rubbish talk. Baxter works with the players every day and knows better. Mazweni7, as he is on Twitter, is wrong. That's Zwei. They're saying you're wrong. Zwei, as I said to you, do the fans think they know more than the double-winning coach, Stuart Baxter? As I speak to you, I've got Deshi Backtower, the old Orlando Pirates goalkeeper, who's going to come and sit next to me now. We need to get him a cup of coffee in a minute, but Gordon Iggeson might bring a cup of coffee along. He normally does. Taking his seat beside me now, Deshi Backtower, the Orlando Pirates goalkeeper. Signed for them in 1990, Deshi, is that right?
Yep, 1990.
Brilliant. Okay, we're just getting Deshi's microphone fixed up. Deshi Backtower, also a fantastic golfer. I think you should know this, guys. He doesn't have the orthodox swing. He has a very slow backlift, but he regularly pounds me on the Irini golf course. And Matthew Patterson last week from Vitz, he also pounded him. I think today we're going to pound Matthew Booth, aren't we?
I think Patterson's playing again.
Is Patterson playing again?
Didn't get enough last week.
Good Geordie lad from Newcastle. What we need now, Comfort, is to get Shakes up. Shakes Kungwane, the former Kaiser Chiefs player, is going to talk to us. Just to fill you in, Deshi, we've just had Zwei Mapala, an ordinary Kaiser Chiefs fan. He's been a fan since he was 6. He kicks the coffee table when Kaiser Chiefs lose. He's a classic fan. And he said to us, mate, we have a right to boo players like Hello? Kingston and Carter. Shakes Kungwane, is that you?
That's definitely me, Neil.
Shakes, I've got a man next to me by the name of Deshi Backtower. He's 7 feet tall. He interviews people like Goodenough Sithole. And he believes in five skippers and Zulu arse. And we're just filling him in on what we've been through so far. He's been on the notorious N1 trying to get here for the last half hour. Shakes, this lad, at Mazweni7 on Twitter, I picked him up basically off Twitter. And Zwei Mapala, he said, he is his name. And he was very good, Shakes. What do you think Shakes, about the booing of certain players. And I'm not just talking about Kingston and Carter. I'm talking also about Nicholas Bentner at Arsenal. I'm talking about Fernando Torres at Chelsea last season when he had a lean patch. Is it good? Is it constructive? Can it be that football fans pay their money to go in so they have a right to boo? Can it be that coaches should listen sometimes to the fans or not?
No, unfortunately, it's a free country and everybody's got his own opinion. But with me, it's so difficult to be booed by the opponent's supporters than be booed by your own supporters. But as much as we could argue about it, the bottom line is, are you building your own player's confidence, or what are you saying? Is it personal, or is it something that happens because the supporters are frustrated because he's missing goals? I think it's got a lot of it's got a lot of things in it in terms of if your team is not doing well, it's like you target a certain player because he's a coach's favorite, or is it? Unfortunately, I haven't experienced it. I remember Nkosi experienced it and it died down. Hopefully this one also of Kingston will die down, because it's so sad to your own supporters booing you. What else you're trying your utmost best? He's trying too much. He's always in positions, good positions, to be in those situations. And unfortunately, he doesn't put it away. And supporters get frustrated. It is understandable. Unfortunately, it's not on.
Yeah, it's not on. That's what you're saying. Hey, Shakes. Well, okay, we also, very, very interestingly, Zwei Mapala, typical Kaiser Chiefs fan, said that he didn't celebrate Kingston and Carter's goal, not because of, the booing of him, but because it was definitely offside. What did you think about the goal?
Well, obviously, it was miles offside. And unfortunately, why one of the best linesmen, you know, Enoch Molefe, didn't pick it up. I'm still surprised. But the movement of the ball, probably they say the advantage given to the attacking team got the better of the linesman and the head official. And look, they all count. Even if it's an offside, it won't change. Yeah, it's a lovely draw.
It's a lovely draw. It's Drolando Pirates, as Zane Moussa was saying last night. We've been saying it for some weeks that Drolando Pirates, not always a criticism. I wrote in the New Age the other week that to call them Drolando Pirates at the moment when three draws got them through to the final of the African Champions League isn't necessarily a criticism. It's a tactical nous on the behalf of Roger De Star, I believe.
Yeah, I mean, for me, unfortunately for the derby, last week, Pirates were favourites. And you could see the first 20 minutes that they played. And defensively, they got caught with that offside goal. But look, they're a complete team. For me, do they miss Lagilo Kwati with his experience and Sangweni at the back? So they're just a complete team. Hopefully they'll make South Africa proud, or the southern part of Africa very proud on Saturday.
Shakes, this is why I love having you on the show, mate. You move us seamlessly from the booing debate on Kingston and Carter, the offside goal in the Soweto Derby. You move us seamlessly into the African Champions League final Saturday night at Orlando. Still tickets available. I have tweeted a link to buy tickets on behalf of Mickey Fusi, Mickey Modisani, just trying to help sell tickets, trying to create a Fortress Orlando. You played for Kaiser Chiefs, Shakes, but you're not necessarily going to come out and say that you're a massive Kaiser Chiefs fan. You're saying that we should all support Orlando Pirates in their quest to beat Al Ahly from Egypt, yeah?
We have to support. I mean, they're representing South Africa, Orlando Pirates. It would be also very nice, the 95 squad that won this probably be invited to the game, you know, because let's not forget, these boys now at Pirates, they're building their own legacy. They know that if they win, that legacy that was built by the 95 guys, it will also be gone. It gives us also an opportunity for Gordon Yeager to say he needs to win the AFCON now, because since we won the AFCON in 96, it shows that the improvement from 95, 96, the boys are getting there. Hopefully, their history will be erased.
Absolutely, mate. Shakes. Also, let's consider this. I'm still getting questions from fans. Deshi, you might be interested in this. We established with Joe Cran, the lad from Soccer Laduma last week, he has phoned CAF. He has been in contact with them. I've also been on to Danny Yordan. If Orlando Pirates win over the two legs, the second leg on the 10th in Egypt, where we hope the referee is not struggling with his whistle or his flag. If Orlando Pirates win, we get two sides in the Champions League next season. Isn't that an enormous boost for South African football after many years?
And also it helps also with the FIFA club football, you know. If Orlando Pirates win this, they'll also be involved with your Barcelona's, your Bayern Munich. It shows the growth of football, especially in our country. Yeah. And if you have one of the two biggest teams in South Africa playing in CAF, it shows that hopefully we might get another team also like your Sundowns, your some of the teams that will be vying to win the league. So the league is also going to be competitive. And everybody will be looking forward to emulate what Orlando Pirates has done. It's a big achievement for Orlando Pirates to reach the final. The kind of teams that they played against, nobody gave them a chance. I never gave them a chance. I never gave Roger a chance. Yeah. I'm very excited. I'm going to the stadium on Saturday. I'll be wearing my black and white. They said black is back.
Black is back.
and hopefully I'm going to Orlando Pirates offices to pick up my Orlando Pirates t-shirt for Saturday's game. And right. I don't want to sit in the suite. I'll be sitting among the fans, singing, and hopefully tomorrow night, I'll go where Esperanza are camping or sleeping,
yep,
and make some noise. We're too nice in this country to give them all the five-star treatment. Once we go to their own country, they treat us rubbish. But hopefully, may the best team win, of which is Orlando Pirates.
Ah, shakes your man off from my own heart. I'm trying to find out exactly. I have found out which hotel they're in. I think it's a bit unfair to announce it live here. But I was hoping that a little choir of gentle Vuvuzela players could play serenade them all night long, like happens to some clubs when they go to Turkey. You might find that there's a big noise outside the hotel. Deshi, I don't know if
you find a hotel for me, Neil.
That's right. We'll find the hotel. We'll send a few nice Vuvuzelas along. So a couple of those green lasers as well. Be nice to get those green lasers just to highlight for the Al Ahly players where the ball is and where your eye is. And that's what they did to us in Tunisia. That's what they did to us in Egypt. I'm all behind. If CAF aren't going to act on the green lasers, if no one's going to complain from Orlando Pirates, which is beyond me completely why they haven't complained, then let's use green lasers ourselves. Let's use Vuvuzelas. Let's use everything we got. Deshi, what do you think? I'm just going to get Deshi in here. Shakes, listen to this.
I tell you what, Neil, you know, this hasn't really changed. From the 90s, when I was involved with the national team, and we travelled. I mean, some hotels didn't have enough food for us at times.
Oh, that's sad.
You know, and the situation of the hotel would almost always be, and I'm sure Shakes remembers this as well, almost always in the centre of town. You know, that's hustle, bustle. The noise just doesn't stop, Shakes.
Yeah, the noise doesn't stop, and even the ladies of the night will be roaming around the street next to your hotel.
No, I don't know if I want to hear that bit.
That's a distraction. I didn't mind about it, though.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, if anyone's got some ladies that they could send along to the Al Ahly Hotel to distract them, to exhaust them, and to take the energy out of their legs for Saturday night, then
we shouldn't make them comfortable as a five-star treatment. I think we should give them a two-star treatment. Yeah?
Two-star treatment, mate. I always felt that. You remember last year, Shakes, Deshi, when we sent that side down to it was the Angolan side. Libido. Yep. No, not libido. I'm getting mixed up with women here. The Angolan side came to Port Elizabeth. Nice day by the beach. Beat Orlando Pirates and out we go. This year, I think we've done it slightly better. And again, to me, the miracle of this season was the win in TP Mazembe. When everything went wrong that could go wrong, two penalties, they actually lost the game. Yep. And ridiculous sending off Lucky Lakwati. Who's Lucky Lakwati again? Yep. I remember him. And I just think that it's been a miraculous run. And I honestly think, even with two draws, with a 0-0 and a 1-1, just like they did in the semi-final against Esperance, I believe that Orlando Pirates and Roger de Sar are going to make us proud on Saturday night.
Hopefully, I'm looking forward to it. As much as I said, I wish they could have booked them at Hillbrow. That would make sense. But unfortunately, they're somewhere in Sandton
They're in Sandton. I can't say where, but yeah, you're right. They're in Sandton, where the British Lions stay. And unfortunately, they're not in Hillbrow, where people throw fridges off the roofs, I'm told. It's been a long time since I went to Hillbrow. Great stuff, Shakes. As always, we look forward to your analysis and possibly Deshi's, whoever's doing the game on the different channels this week. As always, you know, when I watch you and Zane Moussa in particular, having a laugh. What South African analysts I sometimes miss is that when people are watching, they want to laugh along. They want to feel like they're in with fans and Shakes. That's what you do for me all the time. You make me feel like I'm watching a fan and an analyst simultaneously. Thanks, Shakes, for all you do.
Thanks a lot.
And thanks for the chat again today. Thanks, Shakes.
Thanks a lot.
Kungwane, former Kaiser Chiefs player, best left foot I've ever seen. well, in Africa.
This is Bulls Visual Radio.